이 시각 국제 뉴스 온 세계입니다. 두 달여 앞둔 미국 대선, 본격적인 대선 레이스가 시작됐는데요. 오늘 온 세계 초대석, 지난주 마크 김 의원에 이어 미네소타주 공화당 의장 제니퍼 카나한과 얘기 나눠봤습니다. 여성이자 아시아계로는 최초로 미네소타 주요 정당에 당선된 이력을 갖고 있는데요. 카나한 의장, 트럼프 재선에 대해 묻는 첫 질문부터 강한 자신감을 드러냈습니다.
Yes, I believe wholeheartedly that President Trump will be re-elected on November 3rd to serve another 4 years in leading America. The president's popularity and support today versus when he was elected 4 years ago is significantly higher because the president has stood strong against China so that there is fairness and balance in markets all across the world and also in our country for our American-led businesses. And then he's also stood strong in securing our borders and taking a very strong position on an international level.
카나한은 또 트럼프 대통령이 재선에 성공한다면 한반도의 평화와 주한미군 철수, 방위비 문제를 최우선 과제로 삼을 거란 긍정적인 전망을 내놨는데요.
I think for the president, obviously a priority, and we've all felt this around the world, is a concern that we have with North Korea. I think it's balancing the respect of the relationships between our two countries, understanding how to partner in a way that is meaningful to both the leaders of South Korea and the leader of our country and making sure that we have the right strategies moving forward so everybody feels that it's a good outcome, a good strategy and a good position for both countries as we move forward together within the world.
조지 플로이드 사건에 이어 비무장 흑인 남성 피격 사건까지 인종 소수민족과의 갈등이 더욱 심화되고 있는 미국. 트럼프 대통령의 지지율이 바이든에 밀리고 있다는 보도가 연일 쏟아지지만 한인들의 표심에 대해서는 이렇게 바라봤습니다.
Articles will be released out there that will say peoples from diverse backgrounds, including Korean Americans, will vote for Democrats. And that is something that I'm seeing is not true because the Republican Party and this president in particular really support and reinforce and stand behind people going for their wildest dreams and biggest dreams in the world.
이어 카나한은 미 언론이 트럼프에 대해 편향된 보도를 한다며 안타까움을 드러내기도 했는데요. 곁에서 직접 본 트럼프 대통령의 미담도 전했습니다.
Unfortunately, they never really truly share the accomplishments and the position and the connectivity of Republicans and certainly not this president. And it's sad to me that the media continues to narrate that our president isn't inclusive and doesn't stand behind everyone in this country. Because the biggest thing I've learned about him in the few times I've had the chance to meet him is he views us all as Americans and we are all created equal and he wants all of us to be able to have success and live happy lives and fulfill our families.
태어난 지 3개월 만에 미국으로 입양된 카나한 의장. 다양한 민족이 어울려 사는 미국에서 소수의 목소리를 높이며 사는 것이 중요하다며 인터뷰를 마무리했습니다.
I am very proud that I am Korean and that I am from South Korea, even though I don't know who the two people are that gave birth to me. I was basically left to fend for myself on the day I was born. And so I truly do think it's important for me as a Korean American to be able to lift up the voices of people that come from different backgrounds myself, to be able to have good relationships between the United States and South Korea.
트럼프 대 바이든. 두 사람은 9월 29일을 시작으로 세 차례의 TV 토론을 앞두고 있는데요. 국민들의 목소리에 귀 기울여 승기를 잡게 될 후보 누가 될지 지켜봐야겠습니다. 지금까지 온 세계 정혜련이었습니다.